Sir.
Was she in the light?
Who?
You know. No, she's not there.
Not like you would even care if she was.
Mind your tongue, boy! Until our journey is over, one of us must remain focused. Do not mistake my silence for lack of grief. Mourn how you wish. Leave me to my own.
I'm sorry. I didn't realize.
No. Why would you? You do not know my ways. I know it has not been easy. In the light, I felt only moments pass. If that is of some comfort to you.
That's good to know. Really. Go back to Midgard? Face the Black Breath? Or do you think there's more to see in this realm? Sindri said, Mother was a warrior. Was she in a war too?
Of a sort. Her family was decimated by hostile rivals, and she alone survived. She walked the warrior's path, but her war was to live on. To brave an unforgiving world alone.
And that's why she asked Sindri and Brock to make her the axe?
She had the strength to wield such a weapon, and the wisdom to use it for good. She found purpose in protecting the weak.
So, she'd help out the elves?
No.
Father, you ever know anyone else who heard voices?
I knew desperate men at sea who, when our supplies ran dry, would quench their thirst by drinking seawater. They swore the sirens, evil creatures singing to them from nearby islands, were in fact their wives and daughters calling them home. They endangered the crew, steering us toward the reefs.
How did you fix them?
We threw them overboard.
Oh. Well, good thing I didn't drink any seawater. Right?
Yes, it is. How observant.
I am known for my attention to detail. You boys look like you're gearing up for quite the journey. There's an abandoned temple in Midgard that a fellow dwarf converted to his personal storeroom. Packed it with all sorts of treasures he collected during his travels throughout the realms.
Throughout the realms? Which ones did he...
Fafnir was a, shall we say, aggressive collector of magical artifacts. The more he acquired, the more he desired. There was no realm too dangerous, no relic too hazardous. He once ventured deep into Niflheim for a whetstone of all things. Huh. I bet that was quite the whetstone.
Does this story have a point?
Yes, it does! I just happen to have an entry stone to Fafnir's storeroom. You might find something useful in there.
Neat. Thanks, Sindri.
You're very welcome. Oh, and if you find that whetstone, well, it sure would be nice of you to bring it to me. I'd advise caution if you're heading to the storeroom. Last I was there, all manner of nastiness had taken up residence.
Won't your friend be upset if we steal all of his stuff?
Oh, no. No, not at all. He's dead. I think.
Oh, sorry.
No, no need to be sorry. These things happen when one travels from realm to realm, collecting priceless artifacts that don't belong to you. What else was there? To work we go. Sometimes the best purchase is the one we don't need.
Father, I have a confession to make. All those voices in my head, well, this wasn't the first time. Back when we met Brock, his animal warned me about something hiding in the trees. That's why she didn't want to cross.
She told you.
Well, I could just feel what she was feeling, what she was afraid of.
It happens again. You tell me. Understand?
I promise.
Read it.
Yes, sir.
What does it say?
It's about the eternal war for the life. Do you think it'll stop now after what we did?
Unlikely. Have the light. To Midgard.
Looks like this room lets us travel without moving. Brock! We just came back from another realm. And we met your brother. Wait, not in that order.
Did you let that Seedsaw put hand to your blade? Hmm? You do know he lost his talent, right? Just up and left him one day. Tried taking me down with him. Did he botch up on a girl?
Quite the opposite.
Hell, even a blind pig farts up a truffle now and again. But you know what really counts? Consistency. And I got that coming out of all of my parts.
What did you do?
It's better. Good! Now when you're done gawking, I got a favor to ask.